Fitbits, Fitbugs, Fuel Bands, Ups, and Vivo Fits. Everybody's got one, and it seems like every company is making them. But are they actually helping anybody? Fitness trainer Robert Dothard says, absolutely.
It's a big babysitter, and it lets me know what they're doing when they're not training with me. Of course, I know what they're doing when they're training with me.
For the uninitiated, these wearable fitness devices clip on your belt, strap around your waist, or hang around your neck, and measure your daily steps, sleep patterns, and calories burned. They also connect to your smartphone or computer so you can track what you eat.
And I have some clients that combine their nutrition with the Fitbit data, and that has been an absolute home run. And the data that I've received and what I can do to counsel them on their nutrition has just gone through the roof, because before, they would guess.
And it's not just trainers who are excited about it.
It kind of helps me remind myself if I can do better.
I use the app just to get an idea, basically, of, you know, of my daily activity level so that I can adjust my food accordingly.
Yeah, I check it at the end of the day, and if I haven't met my goal, I feel a little bad. I might go like run or take her on a walk or something.
And it's that accountability that Dr. Sharon Hobrisch-Berquist says is key.
Is that balancing your calories is a lot like balancing your expenses. We typically overestimate how much we're saving and we underestimate how much we're spending. And similarly, we typically overestimate the calories that we're burning and we underestimate our caloric intake. So these wearable devices are really a good balancing of the checkbook of calories.
And she says they're actually helping people achieve their goals.
Because even though we know exercise is beneficial for health, currently less than half of Americans are meeting their physical activity goals. And a lot of studies are showing that on average, people walk about 2,000 steps more, and that it does successfully help you lower blood pressure and body mass index.
And if you're overweight, the American Heart Association says that losing just 5 to 10% of your body weight can make a big difference, lowering your risk of high cholesterol, heart disease, diabetes, and stroke. But with all the choices out there, which fitness monitor is the best?
You know, there are a lot of good devices out there, and there are some that may need some work. I always tell clients the best device is the one you're gonna use.
I'm Lynn Berry for CNN.